Hey guys, and welcome in a very rainy Emmeloord for another episode of Digital Classroom. And yes, you see it correctly, and we can already walk a little bit without the crutches. Awesome! Hello, Anouk, how are you doing?
Hey, Frank! Let me get in, it's so rainy!
Okay, Anouk, are you ready for physiotherapy?
Yeah, I am.
Okay, then I'm gonna record the video for the guys about skin retouching. And when you wear a mask, you don't really need skin retouching, right? Okay, let's talk a little bit about one of the things that for us fashion and portrait photographers is without a doubt very, very important. Skin retouching. Now, when you shoot somebody with a digital camera, everything is pin and pin sharp. When you shoot somebody with film, there's actually always a little bit of a bow in your film. So it's never 100% sharp, it's still sharp, but not like you can see every little detail. So with digital, for me, it's very important to retouch the skin. But we don't want to make Barbie dolls, right? There's so many filters out there that change the eyes, that change the nose, the cheekbones. I'm not going for that kind of stuff. I want the skin to be just a little bit softer than the normal skin. In other words, go a little bit more towards film. And up until now, I always used a filter called Imagenomic Portraiture, which works fine. Or you can use, for example, Topaz with Clean Tree. They all work fine. But what if you don't want to go into Photoshop to do your retouching, but you want to do it in Lightroom? Now, as you know, I've been working on a mobile workflow for quite some time, and it's getting there. And even with the release of the new iPad M1, absolutely, that's gonna be fun and it's gonna be awesome for the future. But for now, let's see what you can do in Lightroom alone. A lot of people think that Lightroom is maybe underpowered, maybe just for asset management, but it's so much more. So let's dive into Lightroom and let's create a full skin retouch on the face of Lois in, well, let's say under 10 minutes. There we go. Okay guys, I chose this image from Lois because it's actually shot with pretty high contrast lighting. Now with a big softbox, everything looks nice, right? So let's try it with this shot. Now you do have to realize that when you do skin retouching, you don't want a Barbie doll. So let's make it a little bit more natural. And in Lightroom, that works like a charm. First things first, we have zoomed in on the face. Let's go for selective edits on the right. And then the plus. Now choose a brush and make sure that everything is on 100%. So feather 100. Flow 100 and the brush size around 10 is okay. Now, as long as you don't change any settings and you start painting, you will see that it will actually start painting a mask. And this is what we actually want, because with a mask, you can literally see where you are painting. So let's speed this up a little bit for you guys. Okay, now as you can see, it's way too rough, of course. You have detail lost everywhere, like in the eyes, in the eye, in the lashes, in her lips, in her nose. So we have to refine that mask. Now, the cool thing about Lightroom is actually when you zoom in, you don't have to change your brush size. So now the brush size is actually this, so pretty big. But when I zoom in, you will find out that the brush size, without changing it, actually changes to a more precise brush. And this is ideal for this kind of retouching, because now I can literally zoom in and create some really nice masks, as you can see here. Now, of course, we don't want this to be covered with our mask. So double tap on your Apple Pencil and it will change the brush to the eraser. And also, because I'm zoomed in like crazy, you can see that you have a really fine eraser brush. And this makes selecting images and actually taking selections off, like here, super, super easy and intuitive. Yeah, you know what I mean, right? OK,
Okay, make sure that the eyes are nice and open. And I'm going to switch between the brush and the eraser constantly to make sure that I'm getting the right detail in. So let's speed this up a little bit for you guys. Okay, so far so good. It's okay selection. It can be better, of course, but for now it will do. Okay, now that I've made my selection, it's not important anymore that I see my mask. So now I can start with my effects. Now the first thing I want to do is take out all the really fine detail. So go for texture and go all the way down. And you can immediately see that the skin clears up. Now with clarity, you can bring in some 3D pop or take it out, depending on what you want. I like it in, to be honest, just a little bit. And the third option is actually dehaze. Now, dehaze I don't use a lot, but it can really open up an image. Let me just show you. If you go this way, you can see that I'm creating more contrast. When I go the other way, I'm actually taking out shadows. Now, this looks ridiculous, of course, but anything in between, let's say plus 10 and minus 10, can give you just a little bit of an edge. In this case, I think this will be fine. Okay, now just for fun, press done. And now let's see a before and after. So this is after the retouching, and this is before. As you can see, it's a pretty big difference. It's still very natural, but you take away a lot of that unevenness in the skin. This looks a little bit rough, and this looks nice and smooth. And it isn't overly smooth for me. Now, if you want to go back, it's very simple. Go for your selective edits again. Press the little diamond shape, or whatever it is, and just change your settings. That's the cool thing about working in Lightroom. If you want the texture to be up again, no problem, just change it. You can always go back. And this is one of the main advantages for me working on a RAW file instead of doing it with a filter. Now, of course, with a filter, you can put it on a separate layer in Photoshop and do it that way. But this just works so much nicer in Lightroom. And it just works. Let's be honest, it looks good enough for most work. Okay, so what if you want to take out, like, for example, a little detail, let's say over here somewhere. We're just going to do that. Okay, go for your healing brush and first press done, of course. Go for your healing brush and you can have two options, clone or heal. In this case, I'm going to change it to heal. Okay, just make the brush a little bit smaller, of course. There we go. It was a really huge brush. Okay, zoom in to the area where you want and detail gone. There we go. I think this looks really nice. And you can always change the position where it samples from, as you can see here. And just find a way that it looks nice. And same here. And for example, let's say you want to take this out. And this maybe. There we go. Maybe here. And I'm zoomed in like crazy now, so I have a lot of detail. And I can really dive in and do some really nice retouching work in detail. Okay, cool. Cool enough. And of course, you can also take out some unevenness with your smoothing tool. Now, what is your smoothing tool? Well, it's actually the clone tool with a very low opacity. Let me show you how that works. Let's go for under the eyes. And let's take this darker area away a little bit. Okay, let's first press done. Let's go for the healing brush again, but now choose clone. Okay, take a slightly bigger brush. Feather is okay, but opacity has to be all the way down. There we go. Okay, and now you just paint in the area under the eyes. There you go. And because you are on such a low opacity, you can literally just make it a little bit lighter by just changing the settings. As you can see here, this is too dark. Change the opacity. And now, of course, I'm taking it out of a shadow area, which you don't want because you want to make it lighter, right? So take this part, for example, place it here where it's a little bit lighter. Now you can see that I opened up the eyes very nicely. Opacity all the way up or all the way down, depending on what you like. If you want a more natural look, you go all the way down. Let's say, for example, 5 or 6 or 10. If you want a little bit more, you push it all the way up. But for me, this is too much. So just go down. Okay, very nice. You can change the feather, of course. But as you can probably guess, in this case, the feather has to be 100% up. Okay, and you can do this for the other eye. You can do it for some unevenness in the skin, for example, here. Let's say that you don't want to clone this out, or you don't want to heal it. You want to clone it out, or you want to brush it over. Go for your clone tool and make it a little bit bigger size. There we go. And just, for example, paint over this area. Okay, it will select something where it thinks it's okay. From the wall. Okay, let's place that back here. Okay. And just find the nice detail that you like and then place it there. Okay, now change the opacity, for example, a little bit higher for this part. Okay, there you go. Okay, let's do it before and after. So this is the face, before and after. As you can see, there's so much possible in Lightroom. It's absolutely amazing for skin retouching. Now, if you want to open up the eyes, no problem at all. Go into your selective edits again. Press the plus for the brush. Make it small. And just go over the eyes. And I only do the iris. Okay, now go for light, and the only thing you have to do is just add a little bit of contrast, add a little bit of exposure to the eyes. There we go. Maybe a little bit shadow, a little bit highlights, that's too much. Go down a little bit, and there we go. Press done. Okay, and zoom in to the face. This is after retouching, and this is before. And I spent maybe 10 minutes on the whole image. Normally, when you are really going and you're in your workflow, you can do stuff like this in maybe 5 minutes. You can do a full retouch on the face. I didn't do the neck at this moment, but of course, it goes without saying, if you select more, it will also, of course, translate back to the neck and the hands. Now, when you do skin retouching, don't forget the neck, the hands, and of course, everything else where you see skin. It looks really weird if they have a nice face and everything else is weird. Okay. Now, you can do, of course, a lot more. You can also open up the shadows a little bit, like, for example, in the hair. Go for selective edits again, press the plus, and just paint over the hair. I'm not going to do a lot, but I want to show this for something else that we need it for. Okay, so when you want to open up the hairs, it's very simple, right? Go for light, go for exposure, and go for shadows. There we go. So now you have a little bit more detail there. But if you know that this works on the hair, why shouldn't it work on, for example, shadow areas? Let's say that you want to enhance the shadows a little bit under her chin. So why not go for your selective edits, press plus, go for a brush, and just select under her chin. There we go. And because shadows and highlights are nicely divided from each other, I can now literally make the shadows darker, or maybe just open up the shadows. As you can see here, it's very subtle, but it really gives you a nice natural look of almost like you used a reflector. Let's zoom in a little bit more, that you can really see it. I hope on YouTube you can see the difference. It's very, very subtle. But as mentioned before, when you do skin retouching, it's all about being subtle. It's not about overdoing stuff, like for example like this, that looks terrible. It's about finding the balance between having a really nice natural look and something that looks obviously retouched. There we go. I think this looks pretty nice. Okay, before and after. Okay, guys, you can tweak your image to your heart's content, but because we got so many questions about the skin retouching in Lightroom, I thought let's give it a little bit more of an enhanced look. I hope you enjoyed this. Let's go back to, well, my outside self. As you can see, that's it. And it's all on your RAW file. And that's the nice thing. I can't stress that enough. When you do something in Photoshop, you're always working on a TIFF or a JPEG. Please tell me you're not working on JPEGs, but on 16-bit TIFFs. And 16-bit TIFFs are great, but it is a destructive workflow. Meaning if you change something and you press flatten layers or you press save, it's done. You can't go back. The nice thing about Lightroom is that if, for example, in 2 years you go back to the skin and you go like, I don't really like that skin, let's just tone it down a little bit. In Lightroom, that's no problem at all. You can just change it by changing your local adjustments. So for me, the mobile workflow is something for the future. In the past, save and the image was done.
For the future, I think it's important to realize that now you can do non-destructive edits, save them, and they look pretty good. It's not all up to par with the filters, but it's very, very close. Even for professional work, this works like a charm. So I hope you enjoyed this full rundown of how I do skin retouching on Lightroom. Thank you so very much for watching, guys. If you like what we do, please subscribe our channel, leave comments below, and of course, smash that like button because we really like that. Most of all, tell other people about our channel so we can grow. Thank you, and see you again in the next video. Bye, guys, and stay safe.